In the background image, the rapeseed that was in this field has been harvested and next year's crop has been sown and will be either wheat or barley to ensure crop rotation. Seed was sown into residues, reducing soil loss. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, you will learn how multiple factors contribute to soil erosion. You will consider how natural process and humans influence soil sustainability, and you will analyze how climate change will impact soil sustainability. The Revised Universal Soil Loss Equation, RUSLE, has multiple factors that allow scientists to estimate annual soil loss for a particular site. R is the rainfall runoff erosivity factor. It is the average annual value for the erosion force of a particular rainfall. It is an indication of the amount of rainfall and the peak intensity sustained over an extended period. More rainfall increases runoff. More intense rainfall also has more kinetic energy, so it causes more soil to detach from the ground on impact. K is the soil erodibility factor, which includes both how vulnerable the soil is to erosion and runoff. Soil textures such as clay-rich soils and coarsely textured soils contribute to low erosion rates. Organic matter reduces erodibility because it reduces susceptibility to detachment and increases infiltration, which decreases runoff. Permeability affects runoff. Increase in permeability decreases runoff because infiltration is higher. L is the slope length factor, which represents the effect of slope length on erosion. Slope length is the distance that water travels downhill from the top of the hill to where deposition starts or flow becomes channelized. S represents the effect of steepness of the slope on erosion. Slope length influences erosion because more water accumulates over a longer slope and velocity has more distance over which to build up, effect of acceleration due to gravity. Steeper slopes have a stronger downward component of gravity than do shallower slopes, causing water to accelerate faster and have more erosive power, kinetic energy. C is the effect of cropping and management practices on erosion rates, while P is the impact of support practices, contouring, strip cropping, terracing, etc. on erosion. Canopy and surface cover protects soil from the impact of raindrops and slows surface runoff, decreasing erosion. Prior soil moisture affects rainfall's ability to soak into the soil. If soil is very wet, new rainfall will cause increased erosion from surface runoff. Prior land use can increase or decrease erosion depending on what the use was. Terracing, strip cropping, and contouring reduce erosion from runoff by impeding the flow of water downhill. This is the overall form of the RUSLE equation. The units are in tons per acre per year. Using the equation, answer this question. Keeping all the factors the same, if a farmer changes crop rotation such that contribution of the C factor decreases by one-third, what would that do to the erosion rate, the average soil loss? The erosion rate would decrease by one-third. If the soil organic matter decreases such that K doubles, what could be done, besides adding more organic matter, to keep the erosion rate the same? You need to decrease the value of any of the other factors by half. Which factors are farmers most likely to be able to influence? Did you say K, C, and P? For each item, decide if you think it is influenced more by human activity or natural processes. Support practices. Did you say human? Soil porosity. This can be both. Texture, organic matter, and biological activity are examples of natural processes. Tillage and driving machinery are examples of human activities. Slope steepness? This is mostly natural, except in areas where terracing is a common practice. Surface cover? This is mostly human. Surface cover is everything that protects the soil from raindrops. It can include rock fragments present on the surface, but is dominated by live vegetation and plant residue left on fields and/or mulch. Rainfall intensity. Yep, this is natural. So what controls rainfall? Climate change influences natural processes such as rainfall and heightens the need for human action. The map shows projected changes during summer, the primary growing season, precipitation relative to the recent past as simulated by 15 climate models. The simulations are for late this century, showing changes that are expected to happen by 2080 to 2099. Confidence in the projected changes is highest in the hatched areas. What are the predicted changes for your region? From the RUSLE, we know that these changes in precipitation will impact soil erosion loss, but this equation doesn't allow us to easily consider interactions between the factors to understand how this happens. A systems diagram is another way to think about this and allows us to consider changes in the system more conceptually. Can you think of some bigger systems? Earth is a system composed of the atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere, and geosphere. There must be interaction between the different spheres. Now we are going to focus in on a smaller scale system. We know that precipitation influences erosion, but there are intermediate processes that impact exactly how this works. This systems diagram is based on modeling of the effects of climate change on erosion in various agricultural regions in the U.S. It allows for a more sophisticated examination of how precipitation influences erosion. The next few slides walk through how to read this diagram. The direction of the arrows indicates cause and effect relationships. For example, this area tells us that changes in precipitation cause changes in runoff. If it were pointing the other way, that would mean that changes in runoff causes changes in precipitation. This doesn't make much sense. But the direction of the arrows doesn't tell us how a factor impacts other factors. The plus and minus signs indicate what type of relationship exists between the factors. A positive relationship means that a change in one factor causes an effect on another factor in the same direction. For example, this arrow indicates an increase in precipitation causes an increase in runoff, and a decrease in precipitation causes a decrease in runoff. A negative relationship means that a change in one factor causes an effect on another factor in the opposite direction. For example, this arrow indicates that an increase in crop yield causes a decrease in erosion, and a decrease in crop yield causes an increase in erosion. So we can use this diagram to describe relationships between factors that influence erosion in agricultural systems and predict how changes in one factor will influence other factors. This is a model for Syracuse, Nebraska, which predicts the precipitation will decrease overall for the region. Erosion is also expected to decrease for wheat. Which pathway is most likely to be dominant for wheat? A decrease in precipitation will lead to a decrease in runoff, which will cause a decrease in erosion. Note that this pathway must be dominant to explain the predicted results. It can be expected that crop yield will also decrease due to less available water, which would contribute an increase in erosion, but this must be smaller than the effects of decreasing runoff. Why would a decrease in runoff cause a decrease in erosion? There's less water to carry sediment soil away. The same model predicts that while precipitation decreases overall for the region, erosion is expected to increase for cornfields. Which pathway is most likely to be dominant for corn? A decrease in precipitation will lead to a decrease in crop yields, which increases runoff, which increases erosion. Note that in this case, crop yield must be severely impacted so that even though there is less water around, there is an increase in erosion. Why would a decrease in crop yield lead to increased runoff and/or erosion? There is decreased canopy protecting the soil from the impact of raindrops. Fewer roots and lower organic matter in the soil means less stability, more erosion, and decreased infiltration, more runoff. The dominant pathway for wheat does not include an impact on crop yield, which indicates that this crop is not severely impacted by the modeled decrease in precipitation for this location. On the other hand, the dominant pathway for corn does include an impact on crop yield, which indicates that this crop must be impacted by the modeled decrease in precipitation for this location. This can be explained by the fact that corn requires more water to grow than wheat and takes longer to grow, meaning it needs sustained water throughout the summer. So for corn, the decrease in precipitation decreases crop yields to a degree where erosion actually increases compared to current rates. In the corn-wheat example, we saw that a change in the system can impact individual crops in different ways. What is planted and the management practices employed are ultimately human decisions that have a big impact on the agroecosystem.